series. Well, I'm continuing my experiments with the 4-minute recorder. And one thing I've noticed is that the parameters for doing these transfers with a 4-minute recorder is completely different than the parameters that I'm used to for recording with a 2-minute recorder. But I'm learning the nuances of this stylus, and it cuts completely different than a 2-minute recorder. In fact, there's very few similarities between the 2 and the 4-minute recorder other than the fact that they both record. So I'm just doing a voice recording this on my iPhone as a transfer to a brown wax recording blank using the 4-minute recorder. And I thought I would make a video of the process so you could actually see me cutting this brown wax cylinder. Now the swarf is completely different. The dynamics of the cutting stylus is also just absolutely completely different. It looks nothing like a 2-minute stylus. The recording looks nothing like a 2-minute recording. And it's going to take some additional testing before I can actually get proficient at making good transfers. Now tomorrow I'm going to be taking this recorder apart and transferring the stylus to one of the polymer diaphragms. Right now this is kind of piecemeal together. The original recorder was swollen to the point where it wouldn't fit the carriage, so I basically gutted it and transferred it to a different body. And there is a split, not a big one, but a split in this diaphragm. And so that limits really how loud I can drive it. And so when I put the stylus on a polymer recorder, it's going to be a dramatic difference. But before I went to the effort of doing that, I wanted to learn the nuances of actually recording with a 4-minute recorder, how it reacted, what kind of recording it actually made. And of course, I had to see if the stylus was actually any good. It is surprisingly sharp. And this is an old recorder, circa probably 1912. So we're talking about 102 years old. And while it was fairly battered, it didn't look like it had ever been used. And the stylus under a magnifying glass, which is all I have, it's actually a loop, is surprisingly sharp. There's no chips, it's not dull, it's got a proper cut point. But it is exceedingly small. And again, I've wondered exactly how Edison possibly could have built these by hand. But in any case, just doing a quick recording, transferring this to the brown wax recording blank. Now I'm recording on the Amberola DX. And the Amberola DX is essentially a miniature fireside, a straight 4-minute machine. And of course it originally had the horizontal carriage with a diamond B reproducer. But since it is so similar to a fireside, I took a fireside carriage and I had to modify it by physically shortening the carriage where it rides on the carriage rod. It was much too large to work on this phonograph. But I modified the carriage and it actually worked surprisingly well. And this is the machine I'm now using for my 4-minute recorder until I decide exactly what I'm going to be doing with this. But in any case, just wanted to do a quick recording. Wanted to see what this is going to sound like. And also gives me the chance of actually showing you the process of using a 4-minute recorder. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my email, try to answer it the day I get it. But the new 4-minute recorder is going to open a lot of new possibilities. So again, if you have any questions about recording on the Edison Cylinder Phonograph or anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.
Similarities between the 2 and the 4-minute recorder, other than the fact that they both record. So just doing a voice recording, recording this on my iPhone as a transfer, for a transfer to a brown wax recording blank using the 4-minute recorder. And I thought I would make a video of the process so you could actually see me cutting this brown wax cylinder. Now the swarf is completely different. The dynamics of the cutting stylus is also just absolutely completely different. It looks nothing like a 2-minute stylus. The recording looks nothing like a 2-minute recording. And it's going to take some additional testing before I can actually get proficient at making good transfers. Now, tomorrow I'm going to be taking this recorder apart and transferring the stylus to one of the polymer diaphragms. Right now, this is kind of piecemealed together. The original recorder was swollen to the point where it wouldn't fit the carriage. So I basically gutted it and transferred it to a different body. And there is a split, not a big one, but a split in this diaphragm. And so that limits really how loud I can drive it. And so when I put the stylus on a polymer recorder, it's going to be a dramatic difference. But before I went to the effort of doing that, I wanted to learn the nuances of actually recording with a 4-minute recorder, how it reacted, what kind of recording it actually made. And of course, I had to see if the stylus was actually any good. It is surprisingly sharp. And this is an old, old recorder, circa probably 1912. So we're talking about 102 years old. And while it was fairly battered, it didn't look like it had ever been used. And the stylus under a magnifying glass, which is all I have, it's actually a loop, is surprisingly sharp. There's no chips, it's not dull, it's got a proper cup point, but it is exceedingly small. And again, I've wondered exactly how Edison possibly could have built these by hand. But in any case, just doing a quick recording, transferring this to the brown wax recording blank. Now I'm recording on the Amberola DX, and the Amberola DX is essentially a miniature fireside, a straight 4-minute machine. And of course it originally had the horizontal carriage with a diamond B reproducer. But since it is so similar to a fireside, I took a fireside carriage and I had to modify it by physically shortening the carriage where it rides on the carriage rod. It was much too large to work on this phonograph. But I modified the carriage, and it actually worked surprisingly well. And this is the machine I'm now using for my 4-minute recorder until I decide exactly what I'm going to be doing with this. But in any case, just wanted to do a quick recording. Wanted to see, A, what this is going to sound like, and also gives me the chance of actually showing you the process of using a 4-minute recorder. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my email, try to answer it the day I get it. But the new 4-minute recorder is going to open a lot of new possibilities. So again, if you have any questions about recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph or anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.